So this is my premium accommodation for today. So this is like a RV park and campground run by town. So you can put your tent there, but why would I do that if I have this perfectly fine shelter, right? So chill is packed. The table is too small for me, so no sleeping on the table tonight. But I will put my stretcher outside. There's no moseys, no flies. We're very close to the coast. So should be a good night. I'm going for a little walk. I want to see the water, well, the coast. But this is an interesting scenario here. See, this campground is like right next to the cemetery. Like very, very close. So this is sort of scenario we have today. It's a shame, it's so overcast and cloudy. The clouds are really low, like, I mean, look, they're very, very low, like nearly touching the ground. But it's actually not that cold. It's like probably 20 degrees, so it's quite pleasant. So let's check how cold is the water. Look what I found! Premium bubbles! Right, premium bubbles. Oh, what? Wow! Bubbles! So this is the setup for tonight. But there's so much moisture. You see how much moisture there is? Like mist? Like everything. Everything is just like wet. I don't know if you see it. But yeah, everything is just cool. So this we need to hold. Okay. Yeah. So basically, yeah, this is where I'll be sleeping tonight. And that's the view.
Normally I would use this baby when it's super super cold, but now I use it because it's super super wet in the air. Okay. Okay. And of course, just in case, repellent. Okay. Morning. Actually, it was such a good night. Like, there was no wind, no mozzies, no flies. It was pretty moist, but that's okay. Baby kept me dry. And I just slept all the way through without even waking up. It's so good. Like, I slept for like, I reckon 10 hours. And I had my earplugs. Earplugs are the key to sleeping outdoors. So you just like block yourself to all the noises. And technically speaking, I am next to the cinnamon tree, so in case the ghosts want to talk to me, like my ears, so no one could bother me. Yes, it was a good night, right? Time to pour a coffee, I reckon.
Right, so I've got a stove from Jerry. Thanks, Jerry. And this is my favorite coffee of all time. Vanilla hazelnut. Actually, hazelnut is my favorite, but this one is mixed with vanilla and it's absolutely delicious. And you know, it's so hard to find this type of coffee, like the flavored one, in Europe or Australia. Forget about it. I couldn't find anywhere. You could get hazelnut and vanilla coffee in South Africa and now in Canada. In every shop you can find it. So I am not a... So the way I drink my coffee, I just drink it like that. And then, you know, you pick the grains from your tea. You know, back in the days in Poland, drink common is this is the way people drank coffee. We didn't have espresso machines. That's it. But it smells so nice. You can't smell it, but it's like so nice. Righto. A few more minutes. Take it. Now I'm happy. I need to wait a little. It's too hot. Look at the view today.
Very still. The clouds are very low. Ginny, how was your night?
Yep, she was very happy to be under the cover.
New day, new adventure. Time to hit the road again. And we have a little bit of limited vision today. So I really don't know what I'm doing today because I would like to catch that ferry, which is like 60 kilometers from here, but I'm not sure if it's actually operational today. So let's see how we go. Maybe we find out something on the way because they're not picking up the phone. So it's Saturday today. Okay. Ready. Are you ready to leave? I think you are. Did we leave anything behind? No, we didn't. Okay. Do it. I'm in a good mood. I had a really, really good night's sleep. It was just like this perfect scenario. The temperature was fine, I didn't get cold, just slept all the way through. Right, how are we getting off? Getting off on the little ramp, right. Beautiful.
And just like that, I made it to Pool's Cove. So, there is a ferry that leaves probably in 3-4 hours, something like that. But it only goes sort of halfway where I want to be. So there's two stops. So it only goes to the first one. And I'm pretty sure that little village is only accessible from the sea. There's no road to it. So maybe it would be good for me to stay there overnight. And tomorrow, there's the same ferry would go like one stop, you know, like further. So then I can catch the ferry. So I can catch the ferry to where to the final location tomorrow. And yes, so here we have no reception. There's no restaurant. It's a very, very small town, but there is like a grocery store, little grocery store. So let's see what they have, and maybe we can have a little picnic together with Chili while we're still waiting 3 hours for the ferry. Yes, I think it's a good idea. And turn out this boat is not a ferry. It's some kind of specialized boat. Something to do with salmon, I think. Okay, so for our little picnic, well, baby wipes are for later. So for our little picnic, I bought, this is sort of supposed to be like a ham spread, bread, cheese, and I have some tomatoes. It's gonna be a nice picnic, I think. Let's find a nice spot now. Well, I couldn't find anything here. So there's a little bit of rubbish here and there, but that's okay. It's not smelly, so I think we can easily have a break here. You standing? Right, well, I am at the dump, but it's not smelly, so it's okay, I think. Chili is packed, and we're about to have our little picnic. This one hasn't been used for a while. Let's cut some tomato. Alright. This is a knife. Ha. From South Africa. Right. What did I do? Okay, no, bread. Bread. Let's try this. This is like, so it's supposed to be like a natural smoke flavor. Hemp pate. Looks like, you know, my regular chicken pate. Okay, nah. Okay. Now, tomato. Whoa, stay. Tomato. Salt from South Africa. Still. Pepper. Well, shaker is from Korea. Can you imagine? I traveled with this shaker for 5 years. From Korea. Well, pepper is from South Africa. Whoa, elder. And now we can have lunch. It's a very nice place. This is the life. All right, let's go back to the harbour, see if the ferry's already there and if we be able to get on. Normally vehicles are not allowed on this ferry, it's a small one, but apparently with a bike they sort of like lift it up for you and put it on, so Chili will be in the air for a while. Okay, Chili. Let's do it. Do it. Right, so we made it to Harbour Breton, and now we're gonna go for a little walkie to see the lighthouse. Well, I think it's the only one of the attractions here in this little town. Julie stays. Julie, wait for me. I'll be back. So apparently this walk is about 300 meters. We can do that. Okay, let's see. Oh, that far. Ooh.